Hello, and welcome to the FHWA Innovative Finance video series. My name is Jared Fidelkowski, and I'm pleased to introduce Bernadette Brennan, who advises the Department of Transportation's Build America Bureau on federal loan transactions.
Hello.
Introduction. In this video, we will discuss the TIFIA Credit Assistance Program. The Transportation Infrastructure Finance and Innovation Act of 1998, known as TIFIA, was created to allow state and local governments to leverage their existing federal resources and to encourage new revenue streams and private sector participation to help finance large-scale transportation projects. The TIFIA program offers credit assistance in the form of direct loans, loan guarantees, and standby lines of credit for eligible surface transportation projects. TIFIA is codified in sections 601 through 609 of Title 23 of the United States Code.
The TIFIA program has several objectives. First, TIFIA supports the construction of projects that provide significant public benefits. TIFIA credit assistance can be used to finance many modes of surface transportation, including highway, transit, railroad, intermodal freight, and port access projects. Project sponsors usually pledge revenue from user charges or dedicated taxes to repay the TIFIA loan.
In addition, TIFIA provides federal support to address capital market concerns about higher risk investments. Project sponsors often struggle to obtain financing at relatively attractive rates because project-based revenues can be difficult to predict, particularly for new facilities. For example, in a highway project, although tolls can become a predictable revenue source over the long term, it is especially challenging to estimate toll revenues during the initial ramp-up period of a newly opened facility. TIFIA credit assistance is often available on more favorable terms than in the private market, making it possible to finance projects with difficult-to-predict revenues.
TIFIA also limits federal exposure by relying on long-established practice in the private sector. Projects receiving TIFIA credit assistance are required to receive investment-grade ratings from at least two nationally recognized credit rating agencies, or just one rating if the senior debt is less than $75 million. This also makes it easier for additional debt investors to participate in financing TIFIA projects, allowing public funds to be spent more effectively. In fact, TIFIA financing has proven to work very effectively with private equity investment through long-term public-private partnerships.
Benefits. Sponsors have used TIFIA credit assistance to finance and build projects across the United States, taking advantage of the program's many benefits.
The benefits of TIFIA include long-term, fixed-cost, permanent, and upfront financing. This allows project sponsors to lock in TIFIA interest at closing, reducing financial uncertainty. Funds drawn only as needed. This saves interest costs compared with a traditional bond issuance. Flexible loan structuring and flexible amortization with no prepayment penalty. This allows project sponsors to customize the financing instruments based on their own needs and revenues. For example, if a project provides several years of surplus revenue, the project sponsor can direct those funds toward the early repayment of a TIFIA loan. And finally, relatively low interest rates. Most TIFIA credit assistance is available at the Treasury rate, which can help lower the overall cost to construct a TIFIA-qualified project.
Key elements and provisions. The TIFIA program provides three types of credit assistance for potential borrowers. Direct loans have a maximum term of 35 years from the substantial completion of the project. The U.S. DOT is the lender, and a non-federal entity is the borrower. Repayments on these loans must start within 5 years after substantial completion. With loan guarantees, the U.S. DOT guarantees a project sponsor's payments to a third-party lender. Similar to direct loans, the borrower must start repayments to the non-federal lender within 5 years after substantial completion of the project. And lines of credit are contingent loans that may be drawn upon after substantial completion of a project to supplement project revenues during the first 10 years of a project's operations. The proceeds from a draw on a TIFIA line of credit may only be used to pay debt service on project obligations.
Many types of project sponsors are eligible to apply for TIFIA credit assistance. Eligible sponsors include state governments, state infrastructure banks, publicly sponsored private firms, special authorities, local governments, tribal nations, and transportation improvement districts.
Many types of transportation projects are eligible for TIFIA credit assistance. These include highways, bridges, intelligent transportation systems, intermodal connectors, transit vehicles and facilities, intercity buses and facilities, and freight transfer facilities. Other types of eligible projects include pedestrian and bicycle networks, transit-oriented development, rural transportation infrastructure, passenger rail vehicles and facilities, as well as landside access to seaports.
There are minimum project cost requirements for TIFIA credit assistance. The minimum is $10 million for transit-oriented development, local and rural projects, $15 million for intelligent transportation system projects, and $50 million for all other eligible surface transportation projects.
There are also limits to TIFIA credit assistance. TIFIA credit assistance is typically limited to 33% of the anticipated eligible project costs, unless the sponsor provides a compelling justification for more, up to the statutory maximum of 49%. In addition, a state infrastructure bank may borrow up to $100 million to finance up to 80% of eligible project costs. Under the US DOT Rural Project Initiative, which is aimed at helping improve transportation in America's rural communities, projects are automatically eligible for credit assistance up to the statutory maximum of 49%. An eligible rural project is defined as a surface transportation infrastructure project located outside of an urbanized area that has a population greater than 150,000. These projects must be between $10 million and $100 million in cost, and in addition to receiving up to 49% credit assistance, are also eligible to receive a TIFIA loan at a discounted rate, one half of the Treasury rate.
There are other requirements for TIFIA credit assistance. For example, the project must have a dedicated revenue source pledged to secure the TIFIA loan. This often takes the form of tolls or other project-related revenue. Finally, applicable federal requirements must be followed, which include, but are not limited to, the Civil Rights Act, the National Environmental Policy Act, the Uniform Relocation Act, Buy America, and specific modal requirements. In other words, a highway project would be delivered under FHWA's rules, a transit project under FTA's rules, and so on. As mentioned earlier, projects receiving TIFIA credit assistance must meet National Environmental Policy Act requirements. The US DOT will not obligate funds for a project until it has received a final agency decision, either a finding of no significant impact, called a FONSI, or a record of decision, known as a ROD.
There are also fees associated with obtaining TIFIA credit assistance. A borrower must reimburse the US DOT for the cost of external transaction advisors and must pay an annual loan servicing fee. TIFIA has a program to cover a borrower's advisor fees for projects less than $75 million.
TIFIA credit assistance can finance both development phase activities and construction phase activities. Eligible development phase costs include planning, feasibility analysis, revenue forecasting, environmental review, permitting, preliminary engineering and design work, and other pre-construction activities. Eligible construction phase activities include construction, reconstruction, rehabilitation, and replacement, as well as the costs associated with environmental mitigation, construction contingencies, and the acquisition of equipment.
Process. Now, let's discuss the application process. The Build America Bureau considers TIFIA applications throughout the year. To begin, a project sponsor should contact the Bureau's outreach staff to discuss whether TIFIA credit assistance would meet the project's financing needs.
After consulting with Bureau staff, a project sponsor must submit a detailed letter of interest, allowing the Bureau to assess the project's readiness to enter the underwriting or creditworthiness process. Then, if appropriate, the Bureau will invite the project sponsor to submit fees, indicative credit ratings, and a financial model, all of which are needed to begin the TIFIA underwriting process. Most of the loan negotiation occurs during this underwriting phase, which can take 6 months or more.
Once a project's finance plan meets TIFIA creditworthiness standards, the Build America Bureau will invite the project sponsor to submit a formal TIFIA application. When the completed application is received, the Bureau expects to close the loan within 90 days.
The TIFIA program assesses the strengths of applications in meeting the following 5 eligibility criteria. The creditworthiness of the project. The extent to which assistance would foster innovative public-private partnerships and attract private debt or equity investment. The likelihood that assistance would enable the project to proceed at an earlier date than would otherwise be possible. The extent to which assistance would reduce the contribution of federal grant assistance to the project, and the construction contracting process can commence no more than 90 days from execution of a TIFIA credit instrument.
Combining with other methods. Typically, a project sponsor will need to use a mix of funding and financing techniques to undertake a major project. This can include federal grant funding and state matching funds in combination with innovative finance techniques. This can include GARVIs, state infrastructure banks, public-private partnerships, private activity bonds, Section 129 loans, value capture techniques, and tolling and pricing revenue. Check out the other videos in this series for more information on other innovative financing and funding techniques. Project examples. Now, let's walk through a few examples of projects receiving TIFIA credit assistance.
Our first example is the Capital Beltway High Occupancy Toll Lanes Project in Fairfax County, Virginia. The project created a seamless high occupancy vehicle network in the region. The Virginia Department of Transportation, VDOT, entered into a public-private partnership with Capital Beltway Express, an LLC formed by 2 private investors. For this $2+ billion project, VDOT provided a 75-year design, build, finance, operate, maintain toll concession. And in turn, Capital Beltway Express pledged future toll revenue to secure financing. The USDOT and Capital Beltway Express signed a TIFIA credit agreement in December 2007, providing a $589 million direct loan. In addition to the TIFIA loan and VDOT funding, the project utilized private activity bonds and $348 million in private sector funding. Construction began in spring 2008, and the project opened to traffic in November 2012.
Another example is the Bell Red Street Network in Bellevue, Washington. This project, which is part of a redevelopment plan intended to generate economic growth and transit-oriented development, includes the reconstruction of 12 multimodal roadways. To finance the $320 million project, USDOT provided a TIFIA loan of $99.6 million to the City of Bellevue, while the City of Bellevue used innovative finance measures including tax increment financing, special assessments, and developer impact fees to provide $159 million towards the project. The remaining funding came from federal, state, and local sources. The TIFIA credit agreement was executed in June 2017 and is expected to mature in 2056.
Our third example is the Ohio River Bridges Downtown Crossing Project, connecting Louisville, Kentucky with Clark County, Indiana. The Kentucky Public Transportation Infrastructure Authority issued a design-build contract to construct a new bridge across the Ohio River, carrying 6 lanes of northbound I-65. The project also includes the rehabilitation of the existing adjacent bridge, which would carry 6 lanes of southbound I-65. To help finance this $1.5 billion project, the project sponsors utilized a $452 million direct TIFIA loan and $337 million in Garvey bonds. The TIFIA loan is backed by Kentucky's 50% share of the toll revenue. Construction began in June 2013, and the new bridge opened to traffic in December 2015.
Summary. To recap, TIFIA loans provide federal credit assistance for projects with significant public benefits, while also encouraging new revenue streams and private participation. The TIFIA program also offers flexibility for project sponsors, allowing them to build projects sooner and at a lower cost. For more information about TIFIA credit assistance, please visit the web pages on your screen.
It can be a complex process to assemble funding for a major transportation project. As a first step, a project sponsor should consult with Build America Bureau staff to discuss options and review the pros and cons of using TIFIA credit assistance for your project.
Please note that except for the statutes and regulations mentioned, the contents of this video do not have the force and effect of law and are not meant to bind the public in any way. This video is intended only to provide information and clarity to the public regarding existing requirements under the law or agency policies. Thank you for watching this video. Please check out the other videos in this series for more information about innovative finance for transportation projects.